just sing a song about empowerment. My sisters already got that, you know what I'm saying? I dedicate the song to my sisters. Muslim girls around the world, I'm standing with ya. Tied it up and I'm talking about the henna. You can swipe all day, she don't tender. Cause she stand for the people like Linda. She on a brand like Habib or the silver. Model on the runway like Halima. Got a business like Sayyidina Khadija. Getting looks all the time and it's painful. They call you terrorists, paint you with the labels. But they don't know that you're faithful. Slaying all day, praying all night. It's the boss life, yeah. I'm on with some girls on that boss life. I'm on with some girls on that boss life. I'm on with some girls on that boss life. I'm on with some girls on that boss life.
You don't hear my lie no more. You don't make it rain.
What's up, YouTube, and assalamu alaikum to all of the Muslim sisters and Muslim brothers that are watching. Today I actually have a good topic, something that somebody actually had just recently commented under my last video and said that I should do it. They said that I should do a video basically showing like where do I get my all of my Islamic clothing from, my kimars, my overgarments, my abayas. So today I have some of my kimars and abayas here with me. I'm going to show them and I'm going to add a picture to the side of like where I got them from. And I also have something that I wanted to share with you guys that I do like almost every night, or my mom does it every night, is sage. Like burning sage helps get rid of any negative energies, or like it just helps purify your house or your sage. You just burn it, get a lighter, you burn it right there, and then you let it you know, and the smell, it's like a good smell. It's like, I like the smell. It's a good smell, and it helps like just calm down your soul and just give positive energy, gets rid of all negativity, you know, shaitan, anything that might be going on in your household. And you can get that from Yami Empowerments. My mom sells them. I will put the picture of like her thingy right here on the side. You guys can comment below if you want any contact information or anything. And yeah. Okay, so I'm probably just going to start off with some of the kimars that I have, because I have like a lot of a few handful of overgarments that I'm going to show you guys, and I have a few kimars also, and I'm going to show you guys the tags and where I have gotten them from. So I have this nice peach shayla, nice color. I only wear shaylas, like I don't wear any square kimars anymore, because I feel as though with the square kimars, you can't really do a lot of style. Like with the shaylas, you can do mad different style. But yeah, this shayla I got from, it's nice and stretchy too. So like, I can't, this is like one of my favorite ones, and I don't have to wear a kimar pin with these kind, because it's already gonna, it already fits automatically under my chin, and they don't slide. So I got this from Wadia's Clothing. Here's the tag. And then it says like Diaz in the back. I got this from Wadia's Clothing. And honestly, all of my kimars that I'm showing in this video is from Wadia's Clothing. This is like a beige tannish kind of shayla from Wadia's also. It's the same kind of material, like the exact same material. Stretchy. I don't have to wear a kimar pin with this one. This is definitely like, I wear this all the time. Anytime I wear blue. It's not really, I wouldn't call it really a shayla. I really don't know what kind of, like what's the name, what would be the name of this kimar. But I know it's a ruffled kind of kimar. As you can see, like the material is like ruffled. That's why I kind of like it. It's not really that long. But right here I have it folded into like, so when I do wear it, I have to only have one style I could really wear it with. So, yeah. I have a red one from Wadia's also. It's real thin. You can see right through it. So I fold it. And when I put it on, I fold it over, and then I put it on so that you can't really see through it too much. Now a lot of people been asking me like, do I always get all of my kimars from actual Islamic places? No. This scarf right here is actually from H&M. It's a this is actually a regular scarf, like a scarf that you will wear, that non-Muslims will wear around their neck. This is like a winter scarf. And you know, us Muslims, we could switch it up. They don't have to actually be kimars. We wear scarves too and put it into a, you know, a hijab. So yeah, this was a regular scarf. Olive green, I actually love it. And I fold it in half when I wear it.
So that's actually, so it looks like an actual Shayla.
So I have a shirt here from Wadia's Clothing, and I have a skirt from Wadia's Clothing, and I also have a package from Wadia's Clothing that I haven't opened up yet, but I will open it up on this video. So the shirt says, "That hijabi life, females, you already know, we live in that hijabi life." Then I have this skirt here from Wadia's also. Then actually the peach kimono that I showed you guys, I had got with the to match it. So when I wear this skirt, I wear this kimono to match. And I was like, really popping. So yeah. So I got, it looks like three Shaylas in here. I'm taking out. This is like a canvas, like a bright kind of, not like a brightish yellow, but like a dual kind of bright yellow. I don't really know how to explain it, but I think it actually goes with this shirt that I just showed you guys. So now I have a Shaylas to match, and all of these are Shaylas because, like I said, I don't like wearing squares, like a navy blue Shayla. They're all the same material as the ones that I had showed you guys previously, with like, they're kind of stretchy and they're long. And then this one is white, and I needed a white one, so that's perfect. So get your Shayla from Wadia's Clothing. I will give you guys, I will put the like a picture of the website on the side. Good material. Yeah, that's, I get all of my kimonos from Wadia's Clothing. If not from Wadia's Clothing, they're made with my garment, or I just snatch some up from H&M and make it into a kimono. So now I'm going to show off some of my overgarments that I had, some of them that were made, and some of them that were like ordered or whatever. So yeah, right now I actually have one right now, and this one was from a local sewer that I know from where I live. Her name is Akia. I will not put a picture of her Facebook or anything on here because she doesn't have an actual personal page on Facebook for like her sewing or whatever. But if you are interested in how she sews, comment below, add me on Snapchat or something, and I can get you her contact information. So this is one of my first overgarments that I let her make for me, and it actually came out really good. I like the way that it flows, like as I walk. It's called an A-line swing overgarment, and it looks like a skirt kind of at the bottom, and it came with the belt. I'll show you guys. I'll take it off and show you guys. It came with this belt that you just wrap around your waist and put it like as entire, like a bow or whatever. Sometimes I wear it without the belt. Sometimes I wear it with the belt. You can do it. So I have this yellow overhead overgarment that I got for Eve. This is one of my favorite overgarments. It's so bright. It just gets out there. It's really pretty. So, it's a yellow, a yellow overgarment. It came with the overhead made with, along with it. Yeah, this is one of my favorite ones. Honestly, Zakiya made this. Zakiya, the one that made this one. She also made a black one that I have. So this black one right here is just, I think this was my second overgarment that she made for me. And it's just a regular black. Regular black A-line swing. As you can see, it has a little swinging part at the bottom. And it came with the belt, and it came with the Shayla also. So yeah, right now I have, from Zakiya, I have this burgundy one, the yellow one, and the black one. And pretty so far, they all been so good. The prices are really not that bad. Like I said, if you like how she makes them overgarments, comment below or add me on Snap or DM me on Instagram or something, and I will get you her information, and I will tell her about you guys. I'm going to add pictures of me with everything that I'm showing you guys on, so you guys can see like how I rock them. So this next overgarment that I have is actually a good one. I wear it for my beauty pageant that I ran in, which was for Miss Pleasantville, and it says I Heart Islam. These were really nice. I got these from Owl Hub Clothing. I will put the, she has an Instagram page, so I'm gonna screenshot that and put it to the side so you guys can, you know, go follow her Instagram, and just, the website is on her Instagram, so you guys can go you know, order off there or anything. She delivers. You have to just send her your height. She has these in like mad different colors, and this is an A-line swing also. I love A-line swings because I just like how it swings when you walk. See, it's an A-line swing, nice and long. This one didn't come with the kimono, so I just had a regular black kimono on with. So up next, I have two overgarments from a website called, I don't know if I'm going to pronounce it right, but I'm going to just try to say it. It's pronounced Cadbury, something like that. But I will put the picture of the website right here. You guys can see. So this right here is a black polka dot overgarment. All right, so I have a burgundy one. This is from the same place. Here's like the tag. I don't know. I doubt I was saying it right. I don't know. This is kind of wrinkled. I haven't worn it in a while, so just disregard that. This is a small, and it kind of fit a little. It fit like fitted, like kind of tight. Like it kind of will hug your body. So when you order here from here, just be careful. Get like a medium, just to, you know, make sure it's not too tight. Yeah, this one definitely was a little, like, it was a little tight on me. So when you guys order from that website, Cadbury, just make sure you get, if you're like a small, maybe try to get a medium. If you're a medium, try to get a large, especially if it's a garment that just goes straight down. That's mainly when it's like fitted. Other than that, they come, the shipping is like really, really good. They come, the garments come in like 3 days after you order. That's really good. So that's one thing I like about them. They ship fast. On the website, they have Kimars dusters, like the long little winter kind of sweaters things. They have long cardigans, they have kaftans, Islamic Muslim women's shirts that's kind of long. They have like accessories, a little bit of accessories. They have kimar pins. They have everything on that website. If you want something really fast, go to that website, order it. It comes in within like two to three days. I think that's really good. So yeah. I also have this really, really nice bright blue. Now this is an overgarment, but I don't know the name to it. Like every overgarment has a name to it, like the A-line swings that I wear or overhead garment. This one I don't really know the name to it, but this is like really one of my favorites. It's blue, nice and bright, and Sweet Jenna's made this. They have an Instagram page. I will put that to the side. They do really good. They do a lot of sewing. They make everything. Mainly overgarment, so I'll definitely recommend them. So yeah, Sweet Jenna's. I will put the name right next to this. But all of the places that I mentioned on this video, definitely, you guys definitely should look into them if you guys actually was interested in you know, knowing where I get my Islamic clothing from. So I had went to Dorney Park like a few days ago. Not even a few days ago, I'm lying. A few weeks ago. And when I posted a picture with my Islamic swimming suit on, a lot of people was asking me where did I get it from. So I have my Islamic suit here with me right now.
It's made to be long, of course. And then here's the pants to match. Your blue. It's regular.
Yeah. Then I have the matching hijab. This is the cap that goes under, like this goes under first, and then you got, I got the blue part to match everything else. So I got that, I got this Islamic bathing suit from eastessence.com. I will put the, you know, the link right there. They have way more. They have like mad different colors. They have some with designs on them. They have two pieces. They have one pieces, like, you know, the normal actual bathing suits, but they have them for Muslim women. They're called burkinis. So when you do order them, make sure it comes with a waterproof kimar so that you don't have to worry about getting the water, like, you know, and getting your other kimar wet or have to like just wear a regular scarf. That's where I got my Islamic bathing suit from. You could actually look, like, if you don't want to order them from eastessence.com, just look them up on Google or Amazon, and I'm pretty sure you're going to find more websites that got Islamic bathing suits. But yeah, so everything that I got, I showed you guys, is what I wear. You know, the kind of Islamic clothes that you see more on Instagram with, or and on Facebook. That's where I got all of my stuff from. And anything else, like when I just wear regular clothes, I get like my cardigans and all that simple stuff, my pants and all that stuff from like H&M, Fashion Nova, Forever 21, Old Navy, all the normal female clothing stores. That's where I get all of my other clothes from. But my Islamic clothes I get from different places. I try different people that sew. So yeah, that's a little bit of my background of my clothing stuff. I hope this actually helped out a lot of Muslim sisters that, you know, don't really know where to shop from and stuff. But comment some more topics on what I should talk about, like what should be my next topic. Questions and answers, comment any questions. I will add that into my next video. Make sure you guys tell your friends, tell a friend to tell a friend, subscribe, like, comment, and share to my videos. They're very helpful for any sisters out there and just people that want to learn. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. Make sure you guys hit that like comment, that like button. Make sure you guys like, comment, share, and subscribe, and just stay tuned for my next video. Hit that notification button so whenever I post any videos, you guys got that notification and you can tune right in. Look good, sometimes I don't, I finesse down Western Road, might go down to G-O-D, I go hard on Southside G, I make sure that Northside E, and still, bad things. It's a lot of bad things that they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish on me. Look good, sometimes I don't, I finesse down Western Road, might go down to G-O-D, I go hard on Southside G, I make sure that Northside E, and still, bad things. It's a lot of bad things that they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish on me. Look good, sometimes I don't, I finesse down Western Road, might go down to G-O-D, I go hard on Southside G, I make sure that Northside E, and still, bad things. It's a lot of bad things that they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish on me. Look good, sometimes I don't, I finesse down Western Road, You don't hear my